Only video. Yeah, good evening, class. Yeah, good evening, class. I hope you are okay. Brilliant class you have completed. I am also excited with the sir's teaching. Anyhow, as we continued last class we have seen. Aditi ji, yes, Swinji, next Vikram ji, one more has to join. Anyhow, so in the last class we have seen rise of nationalism in India. In contest to that, I hope you have remembered 1885, one political association we have created, and that political association was Indian National Congress. So today in this class we are going to discuss about the rise of or the formation of Indian National Congress. Before the Indian National Congress, let me clarify one clear idea, class. Indian National Congress was created in 1885, near about 72 delegates. The 72 delegates, mostly they are very loyal to the India, great nationalism, a great patriot they are, we can say. And even they were the English in education, good at English. Okay, they were Indian by birth, but education, everything they have taken in the English. So the Western culture, Western ideology, Western ideas they had with them. So in the context of this Indian National Congress, I would like to say one more thing. One of the Britishers only helped us for the formation of this great institution, right? May you know, is this Indian National Congress about which we are discussing? Do you have any idea, class? Either Aditi ji or SS Viniji, Vikram ji, any idea? This Indian National Congress, which we are discussing 1885. Now, do you have an idea about this Indian National Congress? Is it working or it is a past organization? Any one of you can answer it. Aditi ji? Yeah, Vikram ji, tell.
Sir, I think it's working.
You think it is working, you are not sure, right? Yeah, Aditi ji, any idea about this Indian National Congress, which we are discussing, whether is it having present relevance or not? Present any relation or not? Yeah, Aditi ji.
They're not exactly related, sir, but the present Indian National Congress is from the past one only, but
Exactly. You are correct. The same Indian National Congress at present, which is there, Indian National Congress is a political party, and Mr. Sonia Gandhi is president, and Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Vadra. This party only. We are talking about this National Congress only. This present Indian National Congress, which was formed at 1885, about that party only we are discussing, right? But here I would like to clarify a few ideas. 1885, when this Indian National Congress was created, by that time we were ruled by the British. And you clearly know that the British had an idea. They had a policy, and the policy was popularly called as a divide and rule policy. What is this divide and rule policy? They never allowed Indians as a unity. Indians means who were they? It may be religion, it may be caste. So by that time, 1885, there was a little bit closeness between the Hindus and the Muslims. And that closeness of the Hindus and Muslims, we able to get until 1921. Try to remember these points, you try to remember. 1920-21, when Gandhiji started non-cooperation movement. So by that time, we got the support of the Muslims, and that non-cooperation was not only non-cooperation movement. 1st January 1921, when Gandhiji launched that one, it was called as non-cooperation Khilafat movement. Remember the word Khilafat. I will explain later part what is this Khilafat and all this. Okay, but you remember that. This Khilafat was the Muslim supportive, which we got during this non-cooperation movement. So Indian National Congress able to get the support of this Khilafat also, means Muslims also. Anyhow, these are all things we are going to discuss. 1885. Before 1885, as I told you, we got one national consciousness after the Great Revolt of 1857, we realize that we are the Indians, the feeling of my country, my people, growth of nationalism or national consciousness or renounce, we can say that is the term, the renounce of our Indian history. Okay, Indian history, historians call that as a renounce. So this type of development we are able to get. And to imbibe or to make an unity among the regional people, try to understand, not the national concept. For example, Mumbai or Bombay by that time. Bombay, all the Mahajans, means the trade people, Bombay Mahajan Sabha, Pune Sarvajanin Sabha, All India Farmers Association. Like that, number of groups they made, number of associations they made. But unfortunately, those associations were not recognized by the British. So in the meantime, there was a great British officer only, retired officer, British, Alien Octavian Hume. I hope you hear this name, A.O. Hume, popularly called A.O. Hume. He was belongs to the British, British, and he suggested these people, you make one association which can be taken as a, recognized by the British. With that concept, they created one organization, and that organization met at Bombay. Please note down, these are the important things. Bombay, 28th December to 31st December 1885, under the leadership of Umesh Chandra Banerjee. So he was the first president of Indian National Congress, the same Indian National Congress which had a great contribution. Okay, that Indian National Congress which working till now, it had a great contribution for the freedom struggle also. Gandhiji, Subhash Chandra Bose, Nehruji, Annie Besant, first woman, these all are the leaders till now that going on. That Congress was created with the 72 delegates, and it had three divisions. We can discuss the three divisions. Number one, moderate. Second one is the second period. Moderate is 1885 to 1906 or 1907 also you can take. 1906, 1907. Next, the second phase was 1907 to 1917. And 1919 to third phase was 1919 to 1947. In the 1947, what happened? 1947, for the first time, Gandhiji came to power. So when Gandhiji came to the power, 1997 to 1919 to 1947, it was called as the Gandhian era. So I hope the three phases of Indian National Congress, you got it. One is 1885 to 1907. Let us think, what was this period? This period was popularly called as the moderates. Why it was moderate? Because by that time, the moderate, the leaders, they were the during the initial stage, they didn't have any experience regarding the party, political party. It was a political party. Okay, try to remember. Political party. They have no experience. Newly they created. And they had a little bit of fear about the British also, because British dominated the people. No, so that's why they had a little bit of fear on the British government. In spite of all these problems, they able to maintain their dignity. Dadabhai Naroji, Badruddin Taibji, Umesh Chandra Banerjee, Gopal Krishna Gokhale, such type of moderate leaders were the, by that time they, and Dufferin, one of the most important was none other than, he was also the Britisher, but he supported the Indian National Congress, Lord Dufferin. He had he helped for the creation of the party, but later on he criticized. By that time, Indian Viceroy was Lord Dufferin. Remember that. Lord Dufferin. Okay. So in the meantime, what happened? What was the policies? Let us know what ideology, what policy they believed on. These moderates, they believe on simple methods. Prayer, petition, request, such type of methods they adopted. They never aggressive. They were not aggressive. Whatever the reform they wanted in India, they wanted in a peaceful manner. They are unable to force the British. We need this. No demand. Nothing was there. So please provide this reform. Please reduce the military tax. Please increase the seats in the British Council. By the time in India, the British Council was there, means the British Parliament. Such type of request they did. And the method of demand also very simple. They never aggressive. They didn't demand, we can say. They requested, petition, written request. Such type of methods they adopted. As a result, instead of getting all the reforms, they were simply criticized. I hope you are understanding. We are discussing about the moderate phase. The leaders I told, I hope you remember that. President was Umesh Chandra Banerjee, Dadabhai Naroji, Badruddin Tayabji, okay, Gopal Krishna Gokhale, such type of leaders, very moderate, very simple leaders. Yeah. The demand was more, instead of getting the reform, on the other hand, they got criticized. The moderates, they got criticized. This Lord Dufferin, I was telling, you know, who was the viceroy by that time. So he simply criticized these Congress was a disloyal Babus or the seditious Brahmins. Like that, they criticized the Indian National Congress. This Indian National Congress, early phase or the moderate phase, unable to achieve anything. They demand more and more. But there was a influence of the Muslims. Okay, only one thing we able to get, that they implemented one reform. That was 1909. In that 1909 reform, they able to provide the modelling into reform. That we'll discuss. In the meantime, what happened? Dadabhai Naroji, yeah, this is a simple achievement we can say. In 1887, Lord Dufferin attacked the National Congress. In a public speech, he representation of a microscopic minority. Even he criticized the Indian National Congress by telling that this Indian National Congress is nothing. Do you think that you can achieve the independence with this microscopic number? Such type of criticism, disloyal Babus, seditious Brahmins, such type of criticism he made. So that was not so positive. In this way, they are able to continue that. And if you see the Congress session, it had number of Congress sessions. I'll send it with map with the place where it happened. Bombay, if you'll see, first session 1885, again 1889, 1904. Calcutta, if you'll see, 1886, 1890. So all these dates, I will send it to you. You can get the, with the map, I will send it. That will be helpful to you, class. So anyhow, on this Indian National Congress, we can say little bit helpful. Earlier, we had no such organization which can demand the Britishers, which can, able to put their demands in the British government. We didn't have such type of organization, but fortunately, we were able to get this organization. Anyhow, they are unable to achieve anything, but they are able to present their demands. That is the positive thing, right? But 19, second phase, extremist phase. That was one of the great phase, we can say. The second phase, what happened here? We able to get great leaders. Once you remember, in 1905, the British government declared or applied the divide and rule policy, right? Divide and rule policy. What is this divide and rule? Not only India, class, wherever the British ruled, everywhere the British implemented the policy of divide and rule. What do you mean by the policy of divide and rule? Very simple. They never allowed the unity of a country. It may be India. It may be India. It may be, even in the Nigeria also. Nigeria or the Vietnam, wherever they ruled, they implemented the policy of divide and rule. In India, they implemented. May I get from any one of you, how did they implement that? One province was divided by the Britishers. May I get the province? Yeah, Vikramji, please.
Northeast frontier province.
Northeast frontier province. Yeah, very good, very good. We had 11 provinces. They divided India into 11 provinces. Northeast frontier province, Bengal. To be frank, it was Bengal. Lord Curzon, he came to India 1886-87. He implemented this divide and rule policy. They observed that in India, there was a good unity of Indians, Hindus and Muslims. So they wanted to divide among the Hindus and Muslims. The first step they have taken. And they divided Bengal. Bengal, they divided into two parts, East Bengal and the West Bengal. Okay. So, Aditi ji, West Bengal, may I know what is it now called? Is it with India? West Bengal.
West Bengal?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. It is with India.
Capital city?
Kolkata.
Very good. If it is West Bengal, then what about the East Bengal? Any idea about the East Bengal?
Bangladesh now.
Very good. Now that East Bengal, yeah, we are talking about that West Bengal and the East Bengal. They divided the Bengal, and Lord Curzon also put a nice reason why you are dividing this Bengal. We are dividing this Bengal because Bengal was a bigger province. It is very difficult for administration. From administration point of view, we are dividing Bengal. But hidden reason was not that. Hidden reason was they divided Bengal in such a way that they divided Bengal, East Bengal. A major Muslim communities were there. So they divided East Bengal containing a Muslim domination and West Bengal. West Bengal was a Hindu dominant. So they divided in such a way that they divided Bengal between the Hindus and the Muslims. That was the hidden reason. But they told, oh, we are dividing on behalf of administration. No, that all some, they, yeah, we can say misguided. That division of Bengal able to create a young leaders in India, and they all became the members of this Indian National Congress. Divide and policy rule we are discussing, right? And they, who were they? Lal Bal Pal. I hope you heard the name of Lal Bal Pal. Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, Aravinda Ghosh, Prafulla Chaki, Khudiram Bose, Prafulla Chaki, Saifuddin, Kichlu. What not? These all are the young leaders. Subhas Bose, we can include the Subhas Bose. Of course, the radical movement leaders also we can include. They are none other than the Bhagat Singh, Jai Rajguru, Sukhdev. They also we can include. Of course, this Bhagat Singh, Jai Rajguru, Sukhdev, Aravinda Ghosh, these all are a little bit radical people, but they are also part of this Indian National Congress. Young, energetic, and English. Most important is they read English. They bought the Western ideas. And these leaders didn't agree with the division of Bengal. When Bengal was divided, they were strongly opposed to that. Okay, then they made the agitation. The first agitation was none other than anti-partition agitation under the leadership of Congress. So Congress has taken that. So we can say the first movement led by the Congress under the leadership of these young leaders are the extremists. They were called as the extremists. And 6th August, they visited to the river Ganga. And when they declared this one, when Lord Curzon declared this one, Bengal division in 1905, Swadeshi or the boycott movement were organized in different parts. And that was a great achievement of these moderates. Lord Curzon issues an order on 20th, July 1905, dividing the province of Bengal into two parts, Eastern Bengal and the Assam as one province, and the rest of the Bengal province, namely Bihar, Orissa, as the another province. Because by that time, these all are the, Vikramjit told, that northwest, northeastern province. But the actual motive was to divide between the nationalism in Bengal. The anti-partition movement, as I told you, these young leaders, they started the anti-partition movement on 7th August 1905. That anti-partition movement started with the slogan of, by that time they have written, here one question. Yes, Aswinidhi, can you say that Vande Mataram, who has written the Vande Mataram? Author of Vande Mataram, Sujalam Suflam, do you have any idea? Yes, Aswini, who is the writer or author of Vande Mataram? Okay, Aditi ji or Vikram ji?
Rabindranath Tagore?
No.
Bankim Chandra ji.
Oh, yeah.
Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, and in his book. Yeah, Vikram ji, you have good concept on the history. May I know the book in which he has written that? He has written that. Okay, very good, very good. So the book was Anandamat. He has written a number of poems in the book Anandamat. This Vande Mataram was written, and it was an inspiring for the young leaders. He has praised the India, motherland, and all these young leaders. They inspired by that hymn. Okay, toward the motherland. If you are okay, if you will not divert, I will say one more point. So this is the growing or the growth of nationalism through the songs, poems, or the art, everything. It is not Indian origin. In India, we followed that. Okay, see Rabindranath Tagore's Janaganamana or that Vande Mataram or so many arts, architecture, arts, that is the Bharat Mata. This concept we started from Europe, that was called as a allegory or romanticism. Praise of or the increasing of nationalism through the poems, songs, or the art, architecture, such type of things are called as the romanticism. It was helped during the Greek War of Independence. It was helped at the time of Germany unification, Italy unification. So also, as I told you, these all Congress leaders are very good Western culture. They studied the English. They read the Machiavelli. They read the different type of authors. Okay, as a result, that Western concept they brought to India. So this such type of song they adopted, and it inspiring for them. And they started this anti-partition movement. They took the holy dip in the river Ganga, and they treated or wished each other, not namaste or anything, Vande Mataram. That became a word of inspiration. Motherland, the slogan was actually a part of Bankim Chandra Chatterjee's hymn. The hymn was began with the Vande Mataram. It became a string call for the patriotism to self-sacrifice. The partition of Bengal took effect on 16th October 1905. The leaders declared that day is a National Mourning Day, M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G, Mourning Day. I hope you know the word Mourning Day. So they did not do anything. They took the holy dip 16th October. Okay, 16th October 1905, they took a holy dip in the river Ganga. They tied the Rakhi to each other. That indicates the unity, oneness among them. Then they started the Vande Mataram movement. So it was called as Vande Mataram movement because they have taken the word Vande Mataram movement because they were revolting against the partition, anti-partition movement. Then this same movement is also called as a boycott movement. What is boycott movement? They boycott all the foreign goods for the first time. They did not use anything, boycott foreign goods. So this one movement, different names, Vande Mataram movement, anti-partition movement, boycott movement. Okay, they everywhere, they gave the different type of slogans, national songs of the Bengal. And next, similarly, they spread the different part, Bipin Chandra Pal, Lal Bal Pal, I told, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal. Bipin Chandra Pal toured the several regions, including Andhra. He came to the Andhra also. So this end boycott movement where other instruments used by these extremists. Okay. Mass meetings were organized. Swadeshi, they increased the concept of Swadeshi. The boycott, the foreign good, the use of the foreign good. Right? British goods were proclaimed. They did not use, they collected all the foreign goods, put fire to that. Such type of so many things they did. Handloom, weaving units were created. Next, insurance companies were opened. By that time, P.C. Roy, one of the leaders, he organized a Bengal Swadeshi chemical store. He organized because to give the job for the Swadeshi means what? Giving independent, I mean the using of the own country. They boycott. Boycott including, try to remember, boycott including on the same boycott, we able to get even different national movement, even non-cooperation movement also, we saw the same boycott. Here in the boycott movement, boycotting the schools by the children, boycotting the court by the lawyers, boycotting the jobs by the different type of workers. Everywhere, no British. That was the boycott to the British. Cloth, goods, nothing. They did not use anything. So that movement, based upon that, it was called as a boycott movement. A good response everywhere. So this was one of the greatest achievement of extremist. First mass movement. They're able to involve more number of people from north to south. There was a good response to this Vande Mataram movement. So we can say the first agitation under the leadership of extremists was none other than this boycott movement or the Vande Mataram movement. It continued for till 1908 class. The government, now what was the reaction? Till now we are reading about the action of the Indian National Congress or the moderates, extremists. Then what was the reaction of the government? Definitely there should be a reaction, no? So what reaction? The government tried to suppress the movement. Lala Lajpat Rai, Ajit Singh were deported, they were jailed. Tilak was arrested and given the severe punishment. He was given the 6 years imprisonment. Chidambaram Pillai of Madras and the Gadicherla Hari Sarvottam Rao of Andhra Pradesh, they were also, some of the prominent leaders in the South India, they were also arrested, they kept in the jail. The extreme movement could not survive long because arrest of main leaders, these all are the main leaders, Lala Lajpat Rai, Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, Arvind Ghosh, these all people were put in the jail. So no one's there because first initially, you know, there was no such experience. Newly they were making such agitation, mass agitation. There need a proper guidance. Properly, no other people were, and yeah, Gandhiji also, later on Gandhiji came, but the British government, arbitrary arrest, they arrested the leader without sending to court, directly they put in the jail, that they cannot do that, as like Rowlatt Act. Any idea about the Rowlatt Act? Anyhow, we are going to discuss about the Rowlatt Act in course of time. As like Rowlatt Act, they directly, the police directly arrested and sent into the jail, minimum of 2 years. Such type of repressive measures were taken by the British. They created terror among the Indians, right? And in this way, Vande Mataram movement was started. That was the greatest achievement of this extremist. Okay. Now let us see. They did this much of movement. Then what was the achievement? So now we got one concept, Indian National Congress. Then in the Indian National Congress, how do the British reacted? INC and British government, let us discuss INC and British government. May know INC, when INC, Indian National Congress was created in India, by that time, near about 87-88% of people were Hindus, number one. Try to remember. By the time, Muslim people were also there. But Indian National Congress was a political party. To be frank, it was a political party. It never supported any caste, creed, religion, nothing. It was only a political party. Try to remember. Since then, now the British saw that in this Indian National Congress, some Muslim people also participating. Okay, in this Vande Mataram movement and all this, they observed that there was a good unity among the Hindus and Muslims. Now, first attempt they made by dividing Bengal between the Hindus and Muslims. But that division once again able to bring unity among the Hindus and Muslims. Now that British government encouraged the Muslims to create another party. How did they encourage? Then they gave the wrong concept about the Indian National Congress. How they wrong concept they gave, try to understand a little bit. Time we have, I can complete. Little bit, you try to concentrate. Thing was that Indian National Congress was created. Before Indian National Congress, try to understand. Before Indian National Congress, there was Hindu Mahasabha. All the Hindus of India, they created one organization called Hindu Mahasabha, number one. Along with the Hindu Mahasabha, they even created one organization called RSS. Any idea about RSS, Vikramji, Adityaji?
Sir, Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh.
Very good. Is it working now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is. It is part of BJP, they are telling, but it was not, BJP is part of that. RSS was the oldest organization. Rashtriya Swayam Sevak, one word. Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, Hindu Mahasava, Vishwa Hindu Parishad. Like that, some Hindu organizations they created before Indian National Congress. And in that Hindu organizations, almost all the Indian Hindus, they were the members. Now, when they created this Indian National Congress in 1885, almost all the members of this Hindu Mahasabha or RSS or Vishwa Hindu Parishad, they became the member of Congress. Try to understand. Congress was not a religion group. It was a political group. But most of the Hindu people who were the members of RSS, members of Hindu Mahasabha, members of Vishwa Hindu Parishad, they became the members of Indian National Congress. So definitely, Indian National Congress consists of more number of Hindus. But Hindu never say no entry to any other religion. In that Indian National Congress, a Muslim can be the members, or a Christian, or became a Buddhist or Jainist. All religious people can be the members. But the British propagated in such a way, they misguided the people. They wrongly interpreted the Muslims in such a way that Indian National Congress was a Hindu organization. As a result, they can compete with the Indian National Congress. That wrong concept they created, misinterpreted. As a result, Muslims were also easily convinced with the British. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, by that time the young leader, he also accepted the British influence. He was greatly influenced by the British. Then he organized some of the Muslim people in 1906. They created one Muslim party that was called as Muslim League. So in 1906, we able to get another political party. The party was Muslim League. So Muslim League and Indian National Congress, these are the two ancient political parties of India, which had a great contribution for the struggling or for the independent movement of India, these two parties. Okay, so try to remember this. We'll go to Muslim League later on, but now Indian National Congress, extremist. After the end of this Bande Mataram movement, by the time another leader came to India. She was not an Indian. She was belongs to Ireland, but she was greatly influenced by Indian struggle, Indian freedom movement, and she came and spread up. During the national consciousness, I told her name, Theosophical Society. She was the leader of Theosophical Society. To spread the Theosophical Society, she came and settled down in nearby Chennai, one place called Adayar. There she established, and she was involved in Indian National Congress also. And she was another than Dr. Annie Besant, Irish lady Dr. Annie Besant. So Annie Besant became the member of the Indian National Congress, and she had a new concept. What she demanded on behalf of the Congress to the British government, that you have to provide us home rule. What is the home rule? Now, you British be there in the center. Let us rule ourselves within our country. We can elect our leaders, little bit power. She demanded. And that was popularly called as a home rule. She created one home rule league. But as Annie Besant belongs to Ireland, and she was a lady, and she mainly came to spread the socialist, that is the Theosophical Society. Some of the Indian National Congress leaders were not happy with her. Didn't believe or something. Anyhow, one of the leader, Bal Gangadhar Tilak was supportive to her, and then they created the league, home rule league. Annie Besant took the charge of South India, Chennai. Within few years, more than 200-300 home rule leagues were created. Through that, they provided the pressurized to the British government. So that was one of the important thing we can remember about the British lady. Annie Besant and her home rule. Now let us little bit know about A.O. Hume. A.O. Hume generally believe widely accepted that Indian can good get the independence. She was a great rebellion in 1857, and she had little bit sympathy toward the Indians. Okay, Hume organized Congress A to provide a safety valve to the discontentment among the Indian intelligentsia to form the quasi-constitutional body similar to British government of England, and to discuss the social matter, to create a cordial relation with the British officers. There should not be any struggle with the Indians and the British government. There should be a good relation. With these objectives, he created one organization. But later on, he merged his organization with when we created Indian National Congress, and he became the secretary when W.C. Banerjee, Umesh Chandra Banerjee was the president. He became the secretary. So in this way, moderate and the extremist. In the extremist, today we are able to see two movement. One was the Vande Mataram movement or anti-partition movement. Second one is the Home Rule movement. After the Home Rule movement, it was started in and around 1908 to 1909 and 10. Yeah. In 1909, one great reform we were able to get. Time, yeah, we can complete. So what was the reform once you see? Now India was successfully divided and ruled by the Britishers. Yes, Aswini, did you understand what is the divide and rule policy? Yes, Aswini.
Yes, sir.
Can you say just one sentence? What was that divide and rule policy? Whatever you understood, your view. Yeah, fast. British wanted to divide between the Hindus and Muslims. In India, it was Hindus and Muslims. But if you see, Nigeria also they occupied. In Nigeria, there was a Hausa, Fulani, Igbo, Yoruba. Between these three regions also they divided. It is not only India or Nigeria or any other country. Wherever the Britishers, 56 countries ruled. Okay, wherever they ruled, they mainly try to divide among their people. If there would be a unity among the people, the British unable to rule. So that policy they adopted here, divide and rule policy. And based upon that divide and rule policy only, they wanted to divide this Muslim League, as we know that A.O. Hume wanted to make that gap, the division between India. There should not be any conflict between the Hindus and Muslim. He wanted to bring one gap, bridge between that gap. So such type of steps taken by the A.O. Hume. Another one is a Lord Dufferin. I hope you remember that Lord Dufferin who criticized the Indian National Congress.
This meeting will end in 1 minute. Do you want to continue or you will sum it up?
Tomorrow we will continue.
That's what.
Yeah.
Just sum it
up. Okay, class. Yeah. Okay, class. Just try to know today what was the formation, how we formed the Indian National Congress and its members. First session. We read only first session. Just now I'll send the other sessions also. Next, moderates, what was their contribution? Extremist, what was their contribution? Bengal division, Vande Mataram movement. In the meantime, the contribution of Irish lady, what was the hair league, that is a home rule league. And these are a lot of things we discuss. I hope you can go through that. Next class, tomorrow,